What happened to Qui-Gon's lightsaber after his death? One question that many fans wonder is whatever happened to Qui-Gon's lightsaber after Obi-Wan used it to kill Maul? Well, this answer might actually surprise you. After Qui-Gon's funeral, Obi-Wan started to train Anakin to become a Jedi, but at this point, Anakin had no weapon. Because of this, Obi-Wan gifted him Qui-Gon's lightsaber, and he would go on to use it for the next few years. However, Anakin eventually let the saber go as he'd finally construct his own blue lightsaber. Why was Qui-Gon terrified to be Count Dooku's Padawan? Although we all know that Qui-Gon was the Padawan to Count Dooku, did you know he was actually terrified when he was first assigned to him? Well, on their first day together, Qui-Gon told himself that he was afraid of failing Dooku. In his eyes, he believed that he would amount to nothing, and he felt like he wasn't even worthy of being Dooku's apprentice. However, instead of being upset at Qui-Gon for this, Dooku said that he was proud of him, since most Padawans would never even admit their fears. He ultimately believed that because of Qui-Gon's honesty, he'd eventually become a wise Jedi. How did Darth Plagueis order Qui-Gon's death? After learning about the 9-year-old boy who was rumored to be the chosen one, Plagueis went to go see the prophecy himself. Watching from a distance, he saw as Qui-Gon Jinn and the 9-year-old boy, Anakin Skywalker, were leaving to depart Coruscant. However, as Plagueis laid eyes on Anakin for the first time, he was then haunted by a vision where he saw a black-helmeted cyborg rising from a table. Terrified, Plagueis feared that there was a chance that this boy could be the eventual destruction of the Sith. To avoid this, he then ordered Palpatine to have Darth Maul assassinate Qui-Gon Jinn. By killing Qui-Gon, Plagueis believed that Anakin's training would be incomplete, and the vision he had would then be prevented. However, little did he know that by doing this, it would only make his vision come true. What happened when Qui-Gon's ghost spoke to Darth Vader? Shortly after the events of A New Hope, Vader went on a mission and it led him to an abandoned Jedi temple. Upon arriving, he started to hear voices from the past, one of which was Qui-Gon Jinn. Vader, who was horrified by this, ignited his lightsaber to see where the voice came from, but unfortunately he couldn't see anybody. As Qui-Gon then spoke to him, he referred to him as Anakin and recited his final words before he died, saying that he was the chosen one and that eventually he would bring balance to the Force. However, after hearing this, Vader then all of a sudden heard Obi-Wan's voice as well. As for Obi-Wan, he recited what he said on Mustafar, saying that Vader became the very thing he swore to destroy. Before Vader could react, the voices then disappeared, leaving him confused as to what just happened. Why did the Jedi lie about Qui-Gon Jinn's death? Although we all know that Qui-Gon died by the hands of Darth Maul, did you know the Jedi told the public something completely different? Well, the Jedi shared that Qui-Gon died while trying to leave Naboo, but they never mentioned that it was because of a Sith Lord. They did this so they wouldn't cause panic about the return of the Sith, because even the Jedi themselves feared that there could be hundreds, maybe even thousands of them in hiding. However, this dishonesty only frustrated Count Dooku, who had already left the Jedi Order at this point. Dooku was not only upset with how they lied to the public, but for also putting Qui-Gon's life at risk. Why did Qui-Gon meditate during his duel against Darth Maul? One common question is why during the Duel of the Fates, how come Qui-Gon paused to meditate all of a sudden? Well, there's actually an explanation for this. Qui-Gon used a form of meditation that was called Serenity. Serenity was performed so a Jedi could regain both their focus and their power. This ability can only be performed by Jedi Masters, since it required both patience and a deep connection to the Force. Because of Qui-Gon's fatigue by this point of the duel, this is why he took a moment to use Serenity. He did this to gain additional focus and strength before entering the final room of the duel. Why didn't Qui-Gon wear a Padawan braid? Within the Jedi Order, it was extremely common for Padawans to wear a braid, as it would then distinguish them from everybody else. Many believe, however, that it was mandatory for them to wear this, when in fact it was not. Although it was recommended, it wasn't actually enforced, and there's a reason for this. During the era of the High Republic, not every master required their Padawan to wear a braid, giving them the option to whether or not they wanted to have one. Because Qui-Gon's master was Count Dooku, it leads us to believe that because of his untraditional ways, this is why he never enforced Qui-Gon to wear one. Why did Qui-Gon refuse to join the Jedi Council? Although Qui-Gon obtained the rank of master, many wonder why he wasn't a part of the council. Well, he was actually offered a seat, however, he declined. When Qui-Gon was offered to join, he was shocked. Unlike the other Jedi, he was very vocal about how much he disagreed with the council, but to his surprise, the Jedi found his insight valuable and believed his viewpoints could keep them grounded. After this offer, Qui-Gon spent a lot of time thinking about whether or not he wanted to join. However, in the end, he believed that if he did in fact join the council, he would not only be giving up on Obi-Wan and his training, but he would also lose his connection to the Force. Qui-Gon felt as if the Council lost their ways over the years and were no longer keepers of the peace, but instead politicians. If he joined them, he felt as if he would eventually become just like them. This then led him to choose his own path rather than to join the ranks of the Jedi Council. Did Luke Skywalker know about Qui-Gon Jinn? Although Qui-Gon died way before Luke was even born, have you ever wondered if Luke knew who he was? Well, after the events of Return of the Jedi, Luke discovered many different Jedi records over the years, and one of which was actually about Qui-Gon Jinn. In Luke's journal, he wrote that although Qui-Gon wasn't a Skywalker by blood, he had such a deep connection to their family. He knew that Qui-Gon wasn't only responsible for finding Anakin on Tatooine, but also for training Obi-Wan Kenobi. Luke went on to say that Qui-Gon was also well known for listening to the Force instead of the Jedi Code, which in Luke's eyes really set him apart from everybody else. At the end of the journal, he then wrote that he admired Qui-Gon for learning the path to immortality. How did Qui-Gon sense Darth Maul before the Phantom Menace? Shortly before the events of Episode 1, Maul was sent on a mission by his master, Darth Sidious. However, this journey led him to the planet of Coruscant, where the most unexpected thing would happen. As Maul passed through, Qui-Gon had stepped outside and out of nowhere, he felt a disturbance in the Force. When Obi-Wan asked him what was wrong, he told him that he sensed a shadow passing over him, but for some reason it quickly disappeared. He then told Obi-Wan that although he didn't know what it was, he was sure that the meaning behind this will eventually reveal itself. Safe to say that Qui-Gon ended up being right. Why did Qui-Gon think that he was a horrible master? Although we all know that Qui-Gon trained Obi-Wan Kenobi, did you know that Qui-Gon thought he was a terrible master? Well, in his eyes, he believed that Obi-Wan was such a mature and promising young man, but sadly, he felt like he deserved a much better master. Qui-Gon was convinced that the two of them were so different, because Obi-Wan always followed the rules of the Council, while he, on the other hand, preferred to do things his own way. Because of their differences, he felt like Obi-Wan would never learn anything from him, and it actually started to make him worried. Due to this, Qui-Gon believed that Obi-Wan would be way better off with someone else. Why was Yoda proud of Qui-Gon? Although we all know that Qui-Gon had a rough relationship with the Jedi Council, did you know that Yoda was actually proud of him at one point? Well, in an off-screen moment in Revenge of the Sith, Yoda shared his true thoughts with him through the Force. As the two spoke, he complimented Qui-Gon and thought it was impressive that he was able to learn the path to immortality. However, the more he thought about it, the more he was upset at himself for being so blind to notice how good of a Jedi Master Qui-Gon had always been. Yoda ultimately believed that if him and the rest of the Council just listened to him all those years ago, then maybe things could have been different. Who was Qui-Gon's secret lover? Although we all know that Qui-Gon was one of the wisest Jedi, did you know he was actually in love at one point? Well, when Qui-Gon was just 10 years old, he met a girl named Tal, and as they got older, the two of them became close friends. Eventually, they became so close that they even admitted they had deep feelings for one another. However, one day, Tal was sent on a mission to another planet, and while she was gone, Qui-Gon had dark visions that she was in trouble. To go rescue her, he flew to the planet that she was on, and him and Obi-Wan tried looking for her for many days. Unfortunately though, by the time he found her, she was poisoned, and she eventually died in his arms. Who was Qui-Gon's dark side apprentice? Although we all know that Qui-Gon trained Obi-Wan Kenobi, did you know he had two apprentices before him? Well, his first apprentice was named Fëanor, who ended up becoming an incredible Jedi Knight. However, his second apprentice was named Sanatos, and let's just say he was the complete opposite. After he witnessed Qui-Gon accidentally kill his corrupt father, Sanatos fell to the dark side and blamed Qui-Gon for everything. Because of this, he wanted revenge, so he tried to burn down the Jedi Temple, but luckily, Qui-Gon and his new apprentice Obi-Wan Kenobi were able to stop him. After realizing that he was outmatched by the two of them, Sanatos then decided to kill himself by jumping into a pool of acid. Unfortunately, Qui-Gon never forgave himself for allowing this to happen. If you enjoyed this lore compilation about Qui-Gon and you want to learn more about Darth Maul's best stories, then make sure to click the video in the middle of the screen right here.